This is a Friday Shoes production. Our lesson 4-2 in our book on page 194 is targeting, I can identify proportional and non-proportional relationships. Actually, a very simple concept. Here we are. If two quantities are proportional, they have a constant ratio. Constant meaning the same ratio. For relationships in which this ratio is not constant, if it's not the same, the two quantities are said to be non-proportional. Some people might say not proportional, but it's non-proportional. If they're the same, proportional. If they're not the same, non-proportional. Take a look at the pizza example here. It says, Uptown Pizzeria sells medium pizzas for $7 each, but charges a $3 delivery fee per order. Is the cost of an order proportional to the number of pizzas ordered? Well, first, find the cost of 1, 2, 3, 4, however many pizzas, and make a table to display the numbers and costs. When you do that, you can see here, our one pizza, if we ordered one pizza, they would deliver it. It'd be $7 plus $3 delivery, which would be $10. If you bought two, you'd have $7 plus $7, that's for the pizza, plus that delivery fee of $3. So that's $17. And same with 24 for three pizzas and 31 for four pizzas. Notice how they're just adding on another $7 with a $3 delivery fee being added in once. Next, for each number of pizzas, write the relationship of the cost and the number of pizzas as a ratio in simplest form. You'll see I circled them. That's actually what you set up. Take the 10 and the 1 and make a fraction, or excuse me, a ratio, 10 over 1, that equals 10. Take 17 over 2, that equals 8.5, 24 over 3, that equals 8, and 31 over 4, that equals 7.75. Are those the same? No, they are not. Therefore, since they are not the same, they're not equal, we call this non-proportional. You'll see, since that's a long word, I like to do NP, non-proportional. Take a look at number two here. You can use the recipe shown to make a healthier version of a popular beverage, fruit punch. Is the amount of mix used proportional to the amount of sugar used? Well, let's see here. They got a half a cup of sugar, one envelope of mix, and two quarts of water. That's to make fruit punch. All right, what do we do? Well, find the amount of mix and sugar needed for different numbers of batches. And make a table to show these mix and sugar measures. So they've done it for us. We have cups of sugar, envelopes of mix needed, and quarts of water needed. They've done it for a half a cup of sugar, one cup of sugar, one and a half cups of sugar, and two cups of sugar. For each number of cups of sugar, write the relationship of the cups and number of envelopes of mix as a ratio in simplest form. So you'll see they've taken the 1 half, put it over 1, taken the 1, put it over the 2, 1 half over 3, and 2 over 4, all right here. Are those all equal or are they different? Well, if you look at each one of these, they each equal 0.5. It says all the ratios between the two quantities can be simplified to 0.5. If you had a calculator, you can do that. You'll see each one of those equals a half. So the amount of mix used is proportional to the amount of sugar used. That's how we would spell it. Or save us some time, maybe put down P. All right, you'll give it a shot on this A here. Come on back, see how you do. So as an example two, is the amount of sugar used proportional to the amount of water used? So sugar and water used. Simple. Let's create our fractions, which are our ratios here. 1 half over 2, 1 over 4, and I'm just grabbing these right here. Then I'm doing 1 and a half over 6 and 2 over 8. Are those all equal? Well, guess what? They are. They all equal 0.25, which is 1/4. Since they're all equal, then we say it's proportional. How about B here? At the beginning of the school year, Isabel had $120 in the bank. Each week, she deposited another $20. Is her account balance proportional to the number of weeks since she started school? Since she started school, well, let's create ourselves a little chart. We'll go with how much money she has in the bank after so many weeks. And let's just do four of them. So after the first week, second week, third week, fourth week of school, well, we started out with $120, right? So after the first week, she's going to have $140 because she's going to put $20 in. And then the second week, she'll have 160, then 180, ooh, and then 200. Is her account balance, and this is the balance would be how much she has in the bank at any one time, proportional to the number of weeks since she started school? Well, this one right here would be 140 over 1. This is 160 over 2, 180 over 3, and 200 over 4. Do they all equal the same value? Are they a constant ratio? Well, I hate to say it, but these are not the constant ratios that we thought they were. They do not equal each other. They're all actually different. So we would say that it's non-proportional. Technically, you would say her account balance is non-proportional to the number of weeks since she started school. NP. With that said, you could always review. You can always do and rewatch the video or read the examples in the book or watch the personal tutor videos in the resources online textbook. And as usual, this is a Friday Shoes production.